So I would like to talk about the map, the social media, and what we are doing in ground humanitarian assistance. During in India, there was a disaster in Chennai, floods, South India, and the Nepal disasters. So this 2015, there was a huge flood in South India. It causes huge damage, and a lot of people, they suffered, and the death is very less, but however, it's totally devastated the area, like because of the two consequences, you know, continuous two heavy rainfalls. So we never expected this kind of things in, particularly in the state of Tamil Nadu, because we regularly hit by floods and cyclones, but the main issue in this, what we did is like, you know, we failed to understand our the real things from the past history. The lessons we learned is here is like the understanding the scenario and the understanding the nature. Because if you find this, you know, satellite images, you can clearly see the encroachments and the areas which is caused, like, you know, in the river channel, we have a debris flows and we have a lot of materials deposited in that. Like, you know, we can have a lot of information about the satellite image we couldn't find out. And this is the scenario in 2016 and 1893. And most of the area they filled is the lake area got filled, and because of the lake area filled, we got a lot of area got inundated. And the most of the information during disasters, you know, in it has happened in the South Indian floods, like, you know, a lot of areas in Chennai we got affected, and Chennai is the city, and this is the place in Chennai, and this is in rural area. So I'm just talking about both, like, you know, urban area and rural area, because, you know, most of the people, they concentrate only in urban area, they don't much concentrate in rural area, particularly including the social things, you know. This is what happened in, you know, when there is a flood, immediately people, they just start working on, you know, crowdsourcing. They started working in the city area, so they find out inundated area, they find out the total road blockage, everything. But there is no, you know, information about the rural area. And again, on 2016 Nepal earthquake, we got a very good information from, you know, a lot of people. And this is the scenario which has happened in Nepal. And we got information from Nepal Living Labs, and we worked together with a lot of people. And again, in this case, again, people, they don't immediately trigger the data, right? And so this is Operation Maitri, what we did in India with the Indian Army. These are all some of the areas affected in urban, and this is in rural area. Again, the same problem which has happened, you know, everybody, they just concentrated only in Kathmandu, not in, you know, rural areas. So what, there is a big gap, you know, even in, there is a lot of scenarios are available, but when you come to the nature, when the earthquake has occurred in Nepal, it does not coincide with the scenarios. So the gap is like, you know, we do a lot of work, you know, we do a lot of mapping, we do a lot of things, like, but the users, like, you know, government, like what Serena said rightly, when we go to the government, government don't have, you know, resources to access these maps and access these informations. So what our suggestion would be, like, you know, whatever we do, it should be very simple, it should be communicated easily, and it should be very timely. Thank you.